Chapter 9. So Gatsby's death made the news, and lots of paparazzi came to the house. So, after dealing with the police, photographers, and all the rubberneckers, Nick's the one who tries to plan the funeral. And first he tries to get in touch with the Buchanans, but they have left, and they left no forwarding address. Not that they moved their own stuff, but you get the idea. So, Nick tries Meyer Wolfshine, Gatsby's work friend, who has the cufflinks made out of human molars. But he says it's not a good idea for him to be seen there, so he doesn't come either. Then Nick calls Gatsby's old house guest, the one that played the piano, but all he seems to care about is a pair of tennis shoes that he left at Gatsby's house. They must have been some kicks, because, again, that's all he cares about. So Nick hangs up on. Go Nick. But turns out somebody does want to come to the funeral, and it's Gatsby's dad, who heard about the death on the news. So he comes, and he's like any proud papa would be, and he's so impressed with all of Gatsby's things, and he tells Nick that Gatsby always wanted to change the world, and he shows him Gatsby's book, Hop Along Cassidy, and inside he had written himself his schedule and daily resolves, and on there it has his schedule and how he was going to improve himself. Well, obviously that didn't include bootlegging, but we get to the funeral, and it's a somber day, and the only ones at the funeral are a raccoon, I'm just kidding, Owl Eyes, the dad, and Nick, of course, and some of my Wolfshine's people, but really, after all of those parties and all of his fake friends and Instagram followers, only those people were at the funeral. So it turns out that he really only had one true friend, which was Nick. Really sad. Before he goes, he meets up with Jordan one last time, who actually has the nerve to say that he's dishonest and that she trusted him. And he also meets up with Tom, who tells him that he is the one who told George about Gatsby driving the yellow car. And Nick's almost about to tell him that it was Daisy driving the yellow car, but he chickens out. So Nick goes back to Gatsby's big empty house one more time, and he wanders down to the dock, and he stares at that green light, and he ends with one of the most famous passages in American literature. So we beat on, boats against the current, borne back ceaselessly into the past. Godspeed, old chap.